All right, so we are at IFA 2018, and obviously Philips has introduced a few products. Can you tell us a little bit about what...
Well, let me start by asking you a question. So how many hours of sleep do you need at night?
I would say about 8 hours.
Like to feel refreshed?
Feel refreshed. I didn't sleep that much last night. I don't feel so refreshed.
So you need 8 hours, and you said nine?
8 to 9, yeah.
8 to 9. Now, how many hours do you get usually?
If my son cooperates, 8 to 9.
You will get 8 to 9. Do you ever have days that you don't get that?
Yeah.
Okay, and what about you? How many do you usually get?
7 to 8.
So about an hour less.
Yeah.
Yeah, so that's a pretty typical story. I mean, I think most of us know what we need, and we often get less. And we try to catch up on the weekends. You actually can catch up on the weekends. But we have a product that we came out with that's designed for people in the 25 to 50-year-old range who are not getting what they know they need to feel refreshed.
Yeah.
So it might work for both of you guys.
Yeah.
So this is SmartSleep. This is a headband that you wear to help improve the quality of your sleep. It's really got three components that I'd like to show you. So this is an EEG sensor. It senses brain waves and can tell you what stage of sleep you're in. This is the power unit, okay? And that stores some of the data. And then you've got headphones in here. It's all in a very soft casing. So I'll show you what it looks like when you wear it. This also, by the way, is also for EEG for a reference point. When you have that reference point for that EEG, you can really detect brainwaves.
And you put that behind
on the mat, what they call the mastoid, like right behind your ear.
Okay.
So it just goes on like this. This clips onto the sensor right behind your ear.
Yeah.
The headphones go over your ear. You can feel
so
them. They're soft.
Speakers in there. Yeah.
Soft. And then the EEG sensor goes right here. I'll press the button to turn it on. That's it.
And how's that?
Comfortable to sleep.
Comfortable to sleep.
That's totally comfortable. Okay. Yeah. I mean, anything it takes a little getting used to.
Yeah.
But it's totally comfortable after a couple of days.
Okay.
Yeah.
And how long does it? I mean, how long does it go with battery?
Charge it every morning.
Yeah.
And when you plug it in and charge it, you can sync it with the app and get your data immediately.
Okay.
And there are multiple stages of sleep that you go through naturally when you sleep. We can break it into three stages to make it simple. There's REM sleep.
Yeah.
Which is mostly the second half of the night, that's dreaming. And then there are two kinds of non-REM sleep. There's light, stages 1 and 2, that happens throughout the night. And then there's deep or slow wave sleep, stages 3 and 4. That happens mostly in the first half of the night. Okay, so we now, over the past decade or two, have learned in sleep that slow wave sleep is critical to feeling refreshed during the day. It's critical to cognitive functioning. It's critical to mood. So when I wake, when I don't get enough sleep, I'm irritable. I don't know about you.
Absolutely.
Right?
Yeah.
And to what we call executive functions, these higher order cognitive functions, and including the ability to inhibit like a response to a stressful situation, some of that irritability.
Okay.
So what we do is we detect when you naturally go into slow wave sleep.
Yeah.
And we deliver a natural tones in your ear.
Okay.
1/20th of a second. You won't even hear them. But those tones help synchronize your slow wave and boost the amplitude of that wave.
Okay.
So you get a higher wave, you get more slow wave sleep.
Okay.
And if you're sleeping less, but you get more slow wave sleep, you'll wake up feeling better.
So it's quality, not quantity.
Exactly. I could have said it that easily. Maybe I should have.
And if I may ask, like, have you tested this and has it been statistically significant?
Your studies and stuff? So this, first of all, is based The concept is based on several years of research that has been done, not by us, but by other academicians. I'm an academic researcher too, but I haven't done those studies. And it's been published in top tier journals.
Yeah.
So we know this is really sound science. We've also tested it with our product, and we absolutely see a boost in slow wave sleep.
Yeah.
And we have launched this in a very limited launch in the United States. There are about 500 out there. And we see, I think it's like 96% of the people say they wake up, you know, they give it more than 4 stars on their ratings.
Yeah.
And 70% say they wake up feeling more refreshed.
Right.
Now, this is a little bit of an issue because you have to compare it to when you're going to get, I get 6 hours and I use it, I might not wake up feeling like I got 9.
Yeah.
But I wake up better than I felt if I got six without it.
Six without it, okay.
And I use it myself.
So this product is essentially for people to help improve the quality of sleep.
Absolutely, to help you be more ready for the day.
Are there also other sleep disorders that you're treating with this, or do you have other products like for sleep apnea?
Not with this. We have a whole series of products for sleep apnea.
Yeah.
And we've been, we've been in that business, very big in that business for nearly 40 years.
Yeah.
So we are one of the market leaders in treating sleep apnea.
Yeah.
And I personally have brought a lot of the psychology around engagement to that product, which has improved adherence to that product.
Right.
This is designed for the people who are by choice restricting their sleep.
Right. Yeah.
And we're building other products to help with other sleep disorders, because there are a whole lot of them.
And all of this is connected also with an app, I'm assuming, so you could get insight into your sleeping pattern.
It's a great point, because the other thing we don't want people to do, the best treatment for not getting enough sleep is just to get more sleep, right?
Yeah.
So in this app, we help coach you to getting that better sleep through extending your sleep time and through getting better quality of sleep.
And are you seeing any kind of use cases for it to be connected with other Philips products, like Philips Hue, for example, and those kinds of products?
Yeah, so we're seeing potential to be connected to things like our wake-up light, to be connected to other products like that. And as we come out with other products, we're absolutely going to be thinking about every user experience. If you have two sleep products from Philips in your house and it makes sense to connect them, we're going to be on top of that.
And what are we looking at in terms of retail pricing? And
this is $399 right now. It's a limited launch in the United States, but we're ramping up. Like I said, we have about 500 out there. I think by pretty soon we'll have up to 2,000 out there. So we're getting ramped up, and it's going to be in the fourth quarter. It's going to be launched in a limited launch in DACH.
May I ask, why is it a limited launch? Is it
I think this is the first time we're in this part of the the consumer sleep business.
Right.
We want to make sure we do it the right way, and we're getting ambassadors for our product, so that we have good relationships with those ambassadors, and we iterate on the product to make it best for the user.
Right. So thanks, Mark, for your tips.
All right, thank you.
I guess we'll sleep on it.
All right. All right. You've been awake, and we've been DHRME.